We are asked to simplify the given expression. Because we have a fraction, we treat this as if we have grouping symbols around the numerator and denominator, and therefore we simplify the numerator and denominator separately, and then simplify the fraction in the last step. So beginning with the given expression, looking at just the numerator, we need to find the sum under the square root, because 16 plus 9 is equal to 25. This simplifies to the square root of 25 plus 3 squared. So it's important to recognize that the square root of 16 plus 9 does not equal the square root of 16 plus the square root of 9. We need to find this sum under the square root before we take the square root. Looking at just the denominator, we have multiplication and subtraction. We multiply before subtracting. 7 times 5 equals 35. In the denominator, we have 35 minus 9. Now going back up to the numerator, we need to evaluate the square root and the exponents. Well, the square root of 25 is asking what number times itself is equal to 25, and because 25 is a perfect square, meaning it's equal to 5 times 5, which is equal to 5 squared, the square root of 25 is equal to 1 factor of 5. So in the numerator we have 5 plus 3 squared is equal to 3 times 3, which equals 9. Going back down to the denominator, 35 minus 9 is equal to 26. In the numerator, 5 plus 9 is equal to 14, so the given expression simplifies to 14 and 26. But this fraction does simplify because 14 and 26 share a common factor of 2. To simplify, we divide the numerator and denominator by 2. 14 divided by 2 is equal to 7. 26 divided by 2 is equal to 13. The given expression simplifies to 7/13. I hope you found this helpful.